Power Rangers Time Force, the video game for Game Boy Advance, is loosely based on the Power Rangers Time Force series, where you take control of the Time Force Rangers from the future to apprehend the criminal Rancic and his band of mutants. In fact, the game's introductory level, where you're controlling the Red Ranger from the future through a raided base, is actually a recreation of a scene of the Time Force premiere episode, right down to the point where Red Ranger is taken down by Rancic and you have to find a new one in the year 2001, which is where the majority of the Time Force show took place. Now, on principle, the game adopts the familiar Power Rangers formula that hasn't changed much over the franchise's existence. Bad guy monster terrorizes the city, Rangers fight the monster grows, and eventually dies in the prerequisite Megazord fight. Repeat the process for the next few levels, and that's your game. However, while the Time Force show was contented sticking around in 2001, which seldom, if any, time travel involved, the game deviates from the show's limited narrative and actually forces the Rangers to travel through different time periods and fight up Rancic's forces before they mess with the past. It's a basic, bare-bones storyline with few cutscenes, but it's an idea that would have worked if the game was worth a damn, and unfortunately, that's not necessarily the case. The majority of the game has you controlling your Time Force Ranger throughout these various maze-like levels, fighting off disguised cyclobots and seeking out items and energy pickups that will restore your health or add additional weapons and abilities. You can swap between rangers by pressing select and picking out rangers, and the rangers act as your lives count, so to speak, so whenever a ranger is downed, you'll have to pick another until all your rangers have been defeated and the game ends. But you can bring a ranger back to life if you collect chronomorphers, and if all your rangers are still active, then collecting a chronomorpher will essentially add an extra continue to your continue count. Each Time Force Ranger possesses varying stats such as stamina, speed, strength, and whatnot. But aside from these variables and the color of their suits, all of the Rangers play almost exactly the same way, with none of them possessing unique weapons or special attacks to distinguish the bunch. Say what you will about the old Mighty Morphin video games on the Super Nintendo and their steroid Ranger sprites, but at least those Rangers had unique weapons and attacks. You honestly cannot say the same thing about the Time Force Rangers in this game. Oh yeah, you could also access the Quantum Ranger for a limited amount of time per stage by collecting the Quantum Morpher. But he's no different than the others as far as the moveset goes. In fact, the only superiority he offers over the other Rangers are the maxed out stats. That's it, really. There's nothing else to really distinguish the various Rangers, not even any of the little things. It's rather unfortunate, really. Controls are more or less standard fare in Time Force. The B button punches, A button jumps, and the shoulder buttons are reserved for additional weapons such as Chrono Sabers and Blasters once you acquire them. You can pull off some combos and stuff with these abilities, but ultimately you'll just stick with bashing the B button when it comes to defeating your enemies, since the difference is marginal at best. You do have additional abilities such as double jumping, dashing, air dashing, and charge moves that clear the screen of enemies. Not that it would matter in the long run, because there's not much to the gameplay in general. Other than some platforming elements and navigating the maze-like layouts of the lackluster level design, you're mostly performing endless combos on generic-looking enemies that, while fit the timeline, eventually turn into cyclobots and more endless combos afterwards. Sometimes you're even avoiding the cyclobots altogether and just trying to jump around like an idiot on your way to the exit while avoiding traps and pitfalls of the level. It's all rather dull and monotonous, really. All the boss monsters fight pretty much the same way outside of a couple additional attacks here and there, so it's just a pointless endeavor throughout. Upon defeating the boss monster initially, they'll grow giant size and you'll now fight the same monster with your Megazord in what is nothing more than really rudimentary and bland one-on-one fighter that maintains the crummy gameplay of the Ranger levels. In some cases, it's actually easier because all you really have to do is power up your energy meter to perform your Megazord's crappy finishing maneuver and watch the monster explode brilliantly. And by which I mean not brilliantly. Aside from the uninspired gameplay, Power Rangers Time Force doesn't look all that appealing either. It seems like they were going for a hybrid, cartoonish, photorealistic look to the in-game visuals. I don't know what you would call the art style, actually. That's the best I could come up with. Or how about this? The end result is rather dreadful. Let's go with that. The animation seems to be well done, if nothing else. The rangers, monsters, and what have you seem to move about rather smoothly in terms of the animation, but it doesn't account for the fact that all of these elements are an eyesore, really. You can make up the rangers, they look alright, even if it's the same Red Ranger sprite reused over and over. Certainly better than the steroid rangers from the Super Nintendo days, but I digress. But the enemies are poorly conceived, they look pretty bad, especially the boss monsters, which seem to be original creations for the game, rather than monsters taken from the show, which probably would have been more preferable. Even Rancic's in-game sprite looks like crap. In between levels, they have these intermission sequences featuring these awful stock cartoon imageries of the Time Force Rangers or these poorly rendered CGI monster images. Considering the capabilities of the GBA, I figured they would at least use some stock photos of the series from the Rangers in their suits. You wouldn't even need to show the actors if you wanted to avoid that whole deal, but I guess this was easier, I suppose, using stock cartoons and whatnot. I don't know, it just feels like a really big letdown, considering that the Sega Genesis iteration of the original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers game had these really nice cutscenes that almost looked like they came from the show. But, I guess this could be another prime example of Genesis doing what Nintendo don't, or something like that. Quite possibly the only real positive about Time Force is that they managed to capture a brief sample of the Time Force vocals, and it sounds about as good as it could get on the GBA, even if it doesn't blend with the MIDI interpretation, which isn't all that bad, really. It's not a bad effort, actually, but unfortunately, the designers should have applied some more effort into the music, because the rest of the game's meager soundtrack is drab, uninspired, and just not all that fantastic. Sounds like a monkey banging on a keyboard after consuming several vodka gimlets, and this was the end result of its labor. It's pretty dismal, really. Oh, and the sound effects are rather uninspired and not all that great. It feels really disheartening that the Game Boy Advance iteration of Power Rangers Time Force falls short of being an enjoyable Power Rangers experience on the go, because the older games from the franchise's glory years were actually enjoyable fare and they were pretty decently designed games for what it's worth. Years have passed since the Mighty Morphin age and the franchise had somewhat evolved to the point where the storytelling in later incarnations would have offered enough material for a quality video game if anyone was smart enough to take advantage of it. But even with low expectations, and I mean really low expectations, Power Rangers Time Force is simply a miserable video game. If the monotonous gameplay and uninspired level design doesn't kill this game, the rather mundane audio and craptacular visuals most definitely will. For what it's worth, I like the overall time traveling concept. It's a concept that, quite frankly, I wish was applied to the TV show the game was based on. But at the same time, I also wish there was a good video game worth playing based on that concept. And this game, Power Rangers Time Force for the Game Boy Advance, is clearly not it. Not by a long shot.